Hello and welcome to Opalesque CAMPUS. I'm in Singapore at the Singapore Management University together with Professor Melvyn Teo, and we will talk about what research he's currently conducting, and he will also give us a little bit of history on the Singapore Management University. So please, Melvyn, tell us, what are you doing in Singapore and what type of research are you covering at the moment?
Well, I'm an associate professor of finance at the Singapore Management University. We are a new business school in Singapore, started about 10 years ago. And I basically do research in finance, specifically hedge funds. I also manage a center that does research and education on hedge funds. It's called the BNP Paribas Hedge Fund Center at SMU. We essentially run seminars, conferences, and executive education programs on hedge funds, and we do research on funds per se.
Give us, please, an example of some of the recent research work that you have conducted on hedge funds.
One research work that we've done on hedge funds deals with the liquidity issue for funds. That has been a very big problem in 2008, especially with hedge funds that raised gates and prevented investors from withdrawing their money. We look at whether funds are as liquid as they say they are. As you know, funds grant redemption requests, say on a monthly basis, on a quarterly basis. So we take a look at the funds that are most liquid from this standpoint, the guys who grant liquidity redemption requests on a monthly basis, and see how liquid their investments are. It turns out that when you look at their investments and you look at how their investments correlate with some sort of liquidity factor, you find that a lot of the investments are fairly illiquid. There's a huge variation in the liquidity profile of these funds. As a result, that those highly illiquid guys can earn like 5% more than the more liquid ones. And it turns out that a lot of this liquidity, illiquidity exposure is related to agency problems. The idea that the manager is not the one investing in his or her fund. So a lot of the low performance fee funds tend to have higher liquidity risk. And this liquidity risk will translate to problems for investors when they attempt to pull money out of their fund. So for instance, when investors pull money out of the fund, many times there's a return impact. The return of the fund falls the next month by, say, between 2 to 3% annualized. And this effect is much stronger when stock market liquidity is low, when you have a liquidity crunch like in 2008, everybody's fleeing out the door at the same time, when funds take on a lot of liquidity risk, or when funds are leveraged. So I think this research sort of illustrates the importance of making sure that the assets and liabilities match in the hedge fund industry.
So what can an investor do? What is your recommendation?
My recommendation is that investors need to understand the liquidity of the fund more properly. One way to do that is to look at the past return of the fund correlated with some sort of liquidity measure. Another way is to just simply ask the manager what is the liquidity of the assets that he or she invests in, and whether the liquidity of those assets match the liquidity of his fund. Because if he or she is granting a lot more liquidity than he or she can reasonably provide, given what the fund invests in, then you might be in trouble when other investors try to get out from the fund.
Now, this is something that was, of course, very important during 2008.
Yes.
And also which the hedge fund managers have obviously become increasingly aware of themselves.
Mm-hmm.
How did you see hedge funds react or construct their portfolios and liquidity terms in 2009 differently? In other words, did hedge fund managers react? Were there some real adaptations and changes after the heavy liquidity crisis?
Right. I think coming into the liquidity crisis, fund managers were a bit too eager to accept new money. So they were willing to lower the liquidity bar just to attract investors. Now they have learned this very painful lesson in 2008. Funds increasingly, at least the new ones, are setting up different structures to cater to their own liquidity needs. So they might introduce lockups, increase the redemption period, increase the notice period required before investors can redeem so that they can match the liquidity of the assets with the liquidity of the fund. If they do want to attract investors who care more about getting money quickly when they want to redeem, then they might introduce a fee penalty on those investors. So if you want to go for the more liquid version of this fund, then you will have to pay a higher management fee or a higher performance fee.
Now, you are active here in Singapore. Over the past couple of years, how has Singapore evolved from your perspective as a hedge fund center?
Well, Singapore is commonly known for having fairly friendly regulation. Therefore, we have been fairly successful at attracting many fund managers, especially the smaller ones, where regulation is a cost. So these guys are very happy to set up in Singapore where you have less regulatory hurdles to overcome. We have quite a diverse range of hedge funds. You have macro funds, you have Japanese focused funds, and you have Asia ex-Japan funds as well. So I think the industry here is in for the long haul, and because of the diversity of styles and strategies that funds employ here, we were potentially not as affected by the financial crisis as maybe other places.